Hello, this is Andrew Thake from Minds and Money TV. Delighted to be joined with us today by Soni Dharmawan, Commercial Director of MKU Services. Delighted to have you with us today, Soni.
Yes, thank you, Andrew, for the opportunity for us to share in this Minds and Money session.
Excellent. Let's just start off with a question. A lot of our viewers will not be familiar with MKU Services. Can you tell us a little bit about your company?
Sure. I mean, MKU Services is basically the authorized representative for the Ministry of Energy and Mineral Resources for the Republic of Indonesia. And where we're sitting is basically we're assisting the government on increasing the awareness and informing potential investors on these privately owned mining projects in Indonesia that are basically in the market. Mm-hmm. And when you're talking about, when we're talking about the project itself, it ranges from greenfield opportunities, mining projects, refinery projects. We have over, I think, 15 projects that are in the market with various minerals from gold, nickel, copper, silver, even rare earth metals, among mm-hmm. many others.
Mm-hmm. So how have the last 12 months been for MKU Services?
Well, I'm not going to lie, the recent pandemic has hit these projects really hard. And this is one of the reasons why we're in here, actually. So the private owned project owners came to the government seeking for help in terms of funds. And that's where we step in. The government appointed us to help them to help promote these projects to overseas potential investors.
Mm-hmm. So in terms of if I was to look to invest in MKU, what sets you apart from others in the space?
Well, it's very simple, actually. One thing is the projects that we're trying to put on the market right now are in various stages. We have one specific example, for instance. It's a nickel refinery project located in Banten, Indonesia. Mm-hmm. The status and the stage is actually already 90% completion. So we're talking about the last mile, right? And because of the pandemic and they had financial constraints, so they had to stop the production. Now, it's a very lucrative and high, from our perspective, a very high potential project. Why? Because once they complete, they already have all those contracts signed to produce the nickel ores. So we're talking about everything that's ready to run, and they're looking for the last mile in terms of funds, and they're even willing to give shares. So when you're talking about the schemes itself for the projects, they're very flexible in talking to the investor how much funds they are willing to put in, but ROI is already fixed, everything is fixed. Imagine if you are imagine yourself, an example would be if you make a factory, it's almost already 90% completion and you already have orders coming in, but you can't start producing because the construction has not yet been completed. So it's just like putting a little bit of money and then you get a lot of for your return. And on top of that, I mean, you get the full support from the government as well. This is just for an example, right? I mean, the government appointed us to help these private owned. So there won't be any difficulties in terms of getting license permits, paying taxes, any request that you, our support that you need, the government will support.
Mm-hmm. What other recent news would you like to highlight to investors would you like to highlight to investors who are interested in Indonesia and who are interested in MKU?
Yes. Well, there's a lot of interesting news that has been, that has happened. An example will be last year, the government issued a lot of new regulations for mining. And these are all in favor for potential investors coming in. An example, that's just one. An example of these regulations are now in effect, our centralized platform that has already gone live. So for every single operational processes or license permit, tax payments are all done online and centralized. So it doesn't matter where your mining is actually located on which island in Indonesia, all experience and process are equal. That's one. Another example would be there's new tax incentives given by the government for the mining companies. And what's most, I think, what's another thing that's most interesting is that where previously mining licenses cannot be transferred between stages, now they are, and now it's allowed. So this is to promote junior mining companies to come in and do some exploration. Once they've done the due diligence, they can sell the licenses to a bigger, a more major mining company.
Mm-hmm. So looking ahead to 2022, what opportunities do you see for MKU for the next 12 months? And how are you sort of positioned to take advantage of them?
Well, as I mentioned, on top of the projects that are in financial constraint that the government is trying to increase awareness for investors, there's also a lot of greenfield blocks that the government will be putting in the market in the next couple of months. I mean, starting the next couple of months to a year. And MKU is, again, appointed as the representative for the Republic of Indonesia. And there's huge opportunities in that. We're talking about, like I said, with the new regulations, now it's more acceptable for junior mining. It's not just for major companies to come in and do the exploration. And I mean, there's a lot of potential, especially the fact that Indonesia currently holds the largest reserve for nickel ores in the world. So mm-hmm. we're talking about high potential, yeah.
Yeah. What risks or challenges are facing at MKU at the moment, and how are you looking to safeguard yourself against these?
Okay, well, MKU itself, not so much of a risk, but we're talking about the project owners itself. Of course, like I said, one an example would be they already have contract signed, means deadline is already set, but then they cannot complete their construction because of financial constraint. So that's the biggest risk right there. We're talking about not being able to complete the construction, and at the end of the day, they won't be able to meet the deadline. So it's that's why they're really urgent on getting new fresh funds coming into the projects.
Sure. In terms of just taking more of like a wider view, what do you feel are the sort of top three challenges facing the industry right now?
Well, when of course, one thing is COVID-19, right? Mm-hmm. Although it's already been controlled right now, but still, a lot of that impacts me. That's the major contributor on why they need capital. They're having capital constraint, right? Which mm-hmm. impacts our productivity and the project owners. And it's impacting most of the other industries as well across the country. That's one. Secondly, is that since it's only fairly new that the government has issued the new regulations, it is our job to increase these awareness of the new regulations, which contradicts. I mean, Indonesia is known for their resources and their reserves, right? And a lot of minerals, but they're not really familiar with the new regulations yet. So they're still, in their mind, a lot of them, mining companies and investors are still familiar with the old regulation, where it's no longer the case. So that's the second challenge that we're facing. And the third one is that the government has just enacted a couple of locally owned companies to basically export a lot of raw materials. They're not allowing companies to export raw material ore, so they need to produce it locally here in Indonesia. To me, that is both a challenge as well as an opportunity. A challenge for existing companies, mining companies that are already operating in Indonesia, but it is an opportunity for new investors coming in, creating more downfield, downstream projects to be able to process these ores from the mining companies. So those are the three top challenges, I think, that is facing Indonesia.
We ran our Mines and Money event last week in London. I guess front of mind and what was really discussed at the event in nearly every single panel we had and nearly every single keynote we had was decarbonization, ESG, sustainability, and the green economy. In your view, is the mining industry doing enough to meet the demands from investors to demonstrate ESG credentials? What does it need to do differently?
Well, the good news is the government, and both the government and the private mining companies, are in line with this. And mm-hmm. they are making a lot of changes for Indonesia to achieve a clean and environmentally friendly mining and refining projects. An example would be just last month, Indonesia signed up to the COP26 coal to clean power transition statement, as part of its commitment to reach net zero by 2060. Of course, 2060 is a long time, but the government is trying to push it even closer to 2040 and are seeking international assistance to be able to accelerate this phase to 2040, and also financial and technical support from other countries.
Mm-hmm. So going back to MKU Services, is you've given a lot of reasons as to why investors should consider investing in MKU Services as opposed to other sort of, you know, mining companies and mining opportunities out there. If you had to sort of give an elevator pitch as to what makes your company such a compelling investment, what would it be?
Very simple. We have high potential projects available in the market right now. On top of that, we have new groundbreaking mining regulations issued by the government just last year, and all in favor for the investors. So in my eye, from the view of MKU, today is the best time to invest in Indonesia. And if they don't do it now, then it might be a huge miss. An example would be, we also joined the Mines and Money platform, I think in Australia a couple of months back. Mm-hmm. And one of the projects already been taken by investors. Oh, wow. So yeah, I mean, it's that fast. So while it's still in the market, as you know, there's a lot of huge findings in terms of reserves in Indonesia as well. So you might be the next lucky guy.
So I guess it's just a case of that when the funds are in and the projects start, your projection is that there's nothing but clear skies ahead.
Yes, perfect. Exactly. You summarized it really nice.
Well, we could have carried on for like much longer, but it's always a pleasure to have you, Soni. So that was Soni Dharmawan, Commercial Director of MKU Services, with Andrew Thayer from Mines and Money. Thank you very much, Soni.
Thank you, Andrew. Thank you, everyone.